sick. Little guys in rabbit hats that refused to talk to us, so we did another little mission and we got a spell called Telepathy that lets us talk to them, presumably. And as I mentioned a little bit earlier, I actually lost my save from this game. It's kind of a bummer. I had to recreate it off stream this morning. But as with many NES games, once you know where to go, you can get through it pretty quickly, so it didn't take me long to get back to where we were. I don't think I can damage those guys yet, maybe later. I still have the gas mask equipped, right? Okay, good. This game is pretty cool. It plays really well for an NES title. Like, it feels like it's before its time in a lot of ways. It's very polished. I like that when you charge the attack, that's not just something that's automatic like it is in Zelda. You have to stand still and charge it to get the ranged attack out of it, so you can't use it and have mobility at the same time. This is the Village of Oak. We don't like humans here. Now they actually say something useful because I have telepathy. I can see my boys. He's running in the forest. Have you seen him? Oh, okay. We go look for that thing. Bowser will not talk to humans. Double ellipsis. Here in my house smells like humans. Get out. Okay. Well, I assume that we need to go find the lost kid that's out here, so we're gonna explore the forest here. One thing about this game that is just kind of true of NES titles, and I hope that this increasingly stops being true with modern games, is that often it requires you to talk to some random NPC in a town in order to progress the plot. So, like, for example, this kid being missing in the forest, we did explore this forest very closely last time we played, and there was no kid here. So we had to talk to the mom saying, "My kid is missing," before the kid actually spawned. And that can be the thing that it contributes to, you need a walkthrough to play through the game, or you need to be a kid who has it and just plays it over and over and over until you finally figure out what it is you're actually supposed to do. But you can't really hold that against Crystalis. Like, that's what every game did. Like, that's every Dragon Quest game. One of my favorite games ever, Final Fantasy IV, has that problem. It's very difficult to avoid. The insect flute is a powerful item, but it's dangerous because of the poison insects it calls. The better is Zelda 2. Yeah. Please take this as a reward. You have the insect flute. I swear I'll be God from now on. We shun most humans, but I think you're different from most. Tool shop. I'm good on all that, I think. Nice, coming in, reading their minds, knowing whether they like me or not. There's a monster in the poison swamp. Many of our dwarves were eaten by this creature. The monster cannot attack the village because of an object we possess. We cannot use. I leave this object in your care to save the village. Oh, sweet. I like swords. I like fire. Awesome. We keep the wind sword. I don't know what it does. Ah, we have a different attack now. Cool. So maybe certain enemies are only weak against certain elements. Like the mushroom that we were unable to kill before. I bet we can kill him now. $40? Highway robbery. I need the MP though. Yeah, I can hear that game saucer. Mm-hmm. A little sequence breaking, but then you don't feel like you have to find exactly the right person for the story to progress. But I get why they did it that way. It's a very simple approach to game design and narrative. I'm guessing I have to use this insect flute somewhere, but I have no idea where. Ouch. Somewhere in the forest, presumably. Let's see if there's like a suspicious area somewhere. Getting money, getting paid, also getting fairly decent XP. There might be something we can, like, break with the fire? Shit. We had level 2 for the wind sword as well. That might change later. That doesn't do anything. Yeah, action RPG is a way to think about it. It's much closer to it than Zelda 2. Oh, okay. Where do I go to play the insect flute, I wonder? Huh. No idea. Oh, shit. This game looks really good. Okay, can't attack him while he's spitting acid, it looks like. Ooh, I was lower on health than I appreciated. I do have a refresh spell. Oh, that's right, it's that kind of game. Hold up. Oh, am I this far back? No shit. Hold on one sec. Yeah, I'm a ways back. All right, well, we know what to do, so we can get back there pretty easily. Yikes. '97, this is what game's supposed to take place 10 years in the future. That's what's going on with the title there. Or rather, no, it's significantly further. There's like an apocalypse in the future of our Earth, and then there's this like fantasy reality replaced. It's sort of like Adventure Time, actually, where there is a technology apocalypse and we're still on Earth, but we're in the future and everything's devolved back into, like, sword and sorcery. I think I drew that comparison last time we played. We're gonna go back to that little rabbit town, and we'll actually go ahead and save this time. We're gonna use quick saves. We're not gonna rely on the actual in-game saving engine. Let me see if I can turn it to autosave for me. I can't. Cool. Then I don't have to interrupt the gameplay to hit the save button every so often. I haven't seen my boy since he went in the forest. Triggered. Well, I think that, I think the apocalypse occurred in 1997, which, when the game came out, that was 10 years in the future. And then this world is, like, thousands of years later, because the main character wakes up in this, like, hibernation pod. That's how the game opens up. Easy mode. Insect flute. See, it all moves very quickly when you know what to do. Who are you? You're quite strange. You're the one who's strange. Sword of fire. I don't know, man. This game is amazing. I can't think of another NES game that has aged as well as Crystalis has. Like, you could probably upgrade the graphics of this to 16-bit Super Nintendo graphics and just sell it as an SNES game without making any major gameplay changes. It's pretty right on. I could have bought this as a launch title for the SNES. It has that quality to it. Alright, don't fuck up the boss fight this time. It's kind of cool that they have this boss fight that's in a different perspective to the other fights in the game so far, right? Where it's almost like a Space Invaders top-down. Oh, there's other ads that show up? That didn't happen last time. I do have a heal spell that I can use. I'll try to take advantage of that. I think I have to hit him right in the dead center. Shit, that's correct. Use all my MP for healing. Frame rate slowdown though. Oh! Go back up to full. Goddamn ads. Get out of here. Nobody got time for you. Alright. Rocked. Now I have Ball of Fire. Well, sure, of course, yeah. If it was a SNES game, it would have access to the SNES sound chip, and the graphics would look better. But I'm just saying from, like, a gameplay construction, this feels like it was released around that time. Ooh, wonder if we can open new paths now that we can shoot this big fireball. We'll go into the town and talk to them. Maybe they have new ideas. Now I'm kind of at a loss for where to go next. Training grounds for wise men on the west side. Perhaps you should go there. Thanks for the tip. Thank you again. I'll be good. Yeah, that's the joke. That's how it's used in the movie that it's from. Yeah, reconsidered humans. Hooray! Good, we can live without fear. I originally put my name into something different, but I had to load. The one who saved us, our precious object belongs to you. With this, we express appreciation. Please keep it with you. We will tell all of your feet. Be a hero among the dwarves? The rabbit people are dwarves? Okay. All right, keep the sword. You're great. I think I'll believe in you. I'm gonna go back to the main town where the inn is cheaper. Way. Still can't quite get a one shot out of that, unfortunately. Okay, so our one clue is trading grounds to the west, right? And I can still shoot giant fireballs on the world map. So that might be used as a progress gate. I don't think I was able to fight these guys before without the fire sword. It's kind of a soft block like the graveyard in Dark Souls. Can't climb this yet. You don't have enough power to make it. Okay. Let's drop just a little bit more money. Yep, and that was true. The mushrooms are killable now with the level 2 fire charge, but they were immune to the wind sword. It's kind of cool. I think this might be the training house they're talking about, the one where we got the telepathy skill last time. We'll see if they do anything new now. What's up? Tornado bracelet is somewhere in Mount Saber. It will maximize the power of the Sword of Wind. Okay. Don't think I'm allowed to go to Mount Saber yet. Still can't safely walk on the little swamp land areas in the world map. Oh, that's cool. You can use color to tell whether they're possibly might be able to use color to tell whether that what sword you should use to fight them. They have immunity to a specific one. It's a village where only women live. I wonder. There's the bronze shield. What shield am I using right now? Can't really afford the bronze shield, so it doesn't matter. Yeah. Worry about it later. This guy not talk? Oh wait, here he goes. You go east, you'll find the forest. It's a grand maze where plants will shoot poison. Two steps ahead of you. Get my MP back. You kind of use your MP as a backup source of HP, at least at the beginning of the game, where the main thing you cast spells on is this gear spell. Two routes to Mount Saber, one west and one north. Boat roads are very dangerous. Anything you wish to sell? No, I'm good. Maybe later. Told him that I made a lot of money from stones I found on Mount Saber. For that, he got excited. Have some refreshments. Yeah, we already talked to the wise man. That's how we learned telepathy. Yeah. It's a resource you have to work with. You had much more limited palettes, though, in the NES, so... Not as much room. Ow. So you could technically come down here and just, like, ignore the mushrooms, but I guess that's a way to shunt you in the direction you should be going. Yeah, we never came here. Oh, this song is pretty bumpin'. I think that guy's immune. Oh no, he's still taking damage. Cool. This has a ton of hit points. There's just the one there? Oh no, there's a couple of them. Two shots. That's pretty cool. Ice bridge. See if I can find some songs from this game on the OC Remix. Fire 2 also pierces, which is nice. We'll go check out that, like, cave entrance here soon, too. There's a couple entrances like that. These guys give good money drops. Not terrible. Oh, it's an ice bridge. Oh, it's one way. Okay, that's cool. Didn't realize what it actually was. I think this is right near the entrance. Shit is that? Okay, they're immune to fire. Can only open that probably with the level 2 fire sword. Check both paths. These guys I can still damage, looks like. Two full charged hits. Can do. Warp boots. Cool. I think that lets us return to town directly, which is important in a game where when you die, you start back from your save file. But I have an auto-save stater running to make up for that one small deficiency, although there were still plenty of SNES games that use that model. Even Dragon Quest VIII uses that model. Bravely Default does, but it has the kindness of having an autosave. Ignore the rock mushrooms, they're undamageable. Oh, those guys are too. So let's test this theory. Can I hit them with the Sword of Wind? Oh, okay. They're immune to fire, but not wind. See, that's a really fun mechanic. I guess you also have to switch to the Ball of Wind. Get a charge level 2. It's nice that the Sword of Fire isn't just a flat upgrade, you know? And there it's telegraphed by them being red. Yeah, Blaster Master. There is a good game. We still need the fire sword. Open these things. We'll keep this equipped. Now, can I use this to hurt the mushrooms? No, they're still immune. Oh wait, no, the mushrooms aren't immune, but the Goma spiders are. Interesting. Getting money, getting paid. Not sure if... No, I haven't been here before. It looks similar, but it's technically a different area. It makes me want to go down the other path real quick to see if I'm missing anything. Let me heal real quick. There we go. Did you own this one, Yukipo? Like, how did your paths cross with Crystallis? Let's ignore the dragons for a moment. I just kind of want to explore everything here first. Oh man, this really long branching path. Oh shit! Yikes, that was close. Sometimes in caves, you can scroll a little closer where the enemies are. Magic ring. What's up, dude? You found me, but you have to find the tornado bracelet before I teach you more magic. Okay, I can remember that he's here. What's up with the magic ring? Oh, is it a... Oh, that's a bummer. Okay. It's an ether, but it was consumable, so I should have saved it for a boss fight. Real quick. Let me do a quick save. Oh, too late already. It was right before I went to check. It auto-saves once every minute. That's okay. We know what it does now if we find another one. Yeah, that's really cool. No, I still played plenty of NES games when I had a Super Nintendo. Shit, I still popped open my NES late into, like, the PS2 era. This game called Little Ninja Brothers, it was kind of goofy. Oh, I just got lost. I just completely forgot which way I came from. Okay, this is the only way to go, so... Not as lost as I had worried. The whole point of going there was to bump into Tornell. Now we're in a new area, we're gonna skip the zombies for a minute. Ice zombies. God, they hit pretty hard. Oh, really? If you could get around grinding, it would be a little bit faster, E10. That's still pretty short, but that's a benefit to a lot of NES games. I guess they probably find the most efficient way to grind. Fun to do that pathing. There's probably a point in the game where it is the most correct to do it, you know? And doing it earlier is a waste. Later, Propagable. Thanks for hanging out. See you next time. Thanks for sharing two very excellent games today. We've been here before. Something's fishy. Ah, poison! Man, I ain't even trying to hear that. That's okay. Don't touch the fire poison dragon monsters. I can still knock them back, at least. Nargoma. See, we're circling around now. Okay, that's okay though. I think we know where we're supposed to go. Stay capped out on health. Let's go left this time. Not gonna go down that way. I'm pretty sure that's a shortcut. We've seen where that goes. Oh, I see. Interesting.
Looks a little bit lost.
We've gotta give him more time.
Is there a damage bonus? Oh, interesting. That's all that I was supposed to do. I was supposed to come up here and say, oh, there must be another way through the caves to talk to this guy, but I have to find the thunder bracelet. Which a couple NPCs have told me about, but I don't know where to go for it. Alright, well, let's get out of here. Probably use the warp boots, right? Go back to Bryn Mawr. There we go. Cool. Wait. Stay at the end real quick. I'm actually at a pretty big loss as to where to go next. Yukipo, do you know where the next step is? Can probably look it up real quick if I need to. I'll try going back to the first town real quick. It's not that long of a walk. Ah, it's green version of the fire ones. Okay, I'll Google it real quick here soon. You come back with your new gear and higher levels and these guys are no big deal. That nice RPG feel to it. Just gonna spam sword as we run through here. And some XP on the way. Eat that, Tiger Man. A kingdom for a map. Those guys are immune, interesting, to the fire sword. There's a town down here, right? Hard time going. Oh, there might be another like cavern door that I can open in this area. I seem to remember there being like a blocked off wall. I'll go take a look. Yeah, not necessarily color. Sometimes it is, or better, there's no correlation. Maybe that was just special. This is where we just came from, right? No, this is a different cave entirely. This is not where we just came from. Strange balls hidden in this cave, we already did that. But maybe there's something else in here. We'll look around and see what we can find. Turn down the mill. Behind Zebu. Do you know where Zebu is? I'm not sure where he is. Something over there, but I can't tell if that's a NES like map glitch. Is that there's like another cave here somewhere, maybe? Different cave, okay. I will search. To the left. Thank you, Yukupo. Good looking out. But not the one that goes back to the main town. This one, probably. Yeah, this seems familiar. I remember getting to this. Yeah, that's the ticket. Perfect. Cool, let's see where this goes. Oh. Am I back in the mountain? I might be. Ow. Didn't get poisoned at least. Huh. To figure out where I am relative to where I visited before. Oh, really? Oh, it's a shortcut. Okay. Well, maybe they want us to go back. I didn't actually talk to anybody in the town. If there's a shortcut, maybe we have to go there. So we went right, I think. Well, I didn't do that the first time. Interesting. Wind is filled with sorrow. Return to Leaf soon. Oh, okay. Something has changed now, I guess, by triggering that door. Ouch. This way. Now everyone's gone. Perfect. Can't stay at the inn when no one's there? Come on, the beds are free. Dang it, Bobby. I think I'm just poisoned forever until I get an antidote. Some evil people attacked and took everyone away. I might need to, like, use an item. Use a warp boot to go back to Bryn Mawr. If I don't die. This is where I started. I unfroze all Fry style. Correct number of beds. Yeah. If I were to use a warp boot, I could buy another one from the town. I think I have to do it. I'm just gonna die if I don't. I probably need to buy some more antidotes as well. Oops. Alright. So stay at the inn. I presume the inn removes poison. About to find out, I guess. Okay, that works. So this guy just sells armor, but no regular items. It's fine. Antidote! Just need one. Restock on the warp boots. We know that if we want to come back here to get more warp boots, we should at least have $65 to replace them. So we can farm for it in the future if we absolutely need to. I've got a backup antidote. Let's get moving. I guess the only place I really have to check is back to Mount Saber. So when we were looking for the ice wall, I went ahead and looked up a short, like, hint-based walkthrough. Doesn't have images or anything. It says it involves using the rabbit boots to climb up one of these things you see here. I think I still have one of those. Let me check. Although maybe they're permanent? I don't know. We'll find out. Because normally you can't climb these. You slide down. But, I think if you use the rabbit boots, you can do it. Thing is, though, I don't know how they work. Rabbit boots are permanent. Do you know how to trigger them? That part I'm stuck on. It's not the magic button. Oh, you have to unequip refresh. Okay, thank you. That's what I need to know. Got it. Cool how that works. Like, the longer your feet are touching it, the more slippery you are. That's how it works. Okay, so we hadn't come here yet. Only have one thing. Shit. Got some antidote. There we go. Don't let the poison guy touch you. Hey, tornado bracelet. Oh. Question then is, what does that do? Oh, it upgrades the wind sword. Somebody actually told us that. I should have known that. Level 3. That's pretty sweet. I like it. Kind of jump over them. Alright, so we gotta go slowly find our way back to Toriel. Tornel. Alright. What's for dinner, Stranderson? That's pretty cool. Can't tell if that's damaging or not. Oh no, they're immune to it. Jump over them though. Alright. Alright, give us the rock's feather. I appreciate that I could be using the rabbit thing for that the whole game. Oh wait, we know this just goes back to Leaf. I'm gonna go the other way. Shit. Luckily we didn't get poisoned there. I have warp shoes though. Look how that hits them multiple times if it pushes them far enough back. And now we're out of MP, so we'll throw. We may as well just keep the rabbit boots on for the rest of the time here. Yeah, more buttons, exactly. It's not the fault of Crystallis. It can't give itself more buttons, you know? Continue killing the fire guys, I think. I can find my way back to Tornell. Dang it, Tornell. When you go in reverse, things come from behind. I want to kill some of them just to get the money. Now why does this not- oh, I see. When it's a level 3 shot, it costs MP. I was wondering why I was out of MP. Gotcha. Lesson learned. Ow. Means we should be extra special careful about using it too much in the future and wasting future ethers, magic rings. Be south. It's around here somewhere, I believe. No, that's where we see him, so it must be up through the other path. Yeah, who's the company behind this game again? I'd love to see another Crystallis, you know, do it like Kid Icarus style and say, hey, here's this old NES property. We're gonna get Masahiro Sakurai or somebody. Crystallis 2. Star Tropics is the other one. Should get more games. Surprise, you made it back. Now I'll teach you teleport. This magic allows you to move from town to town instantly. That's pretty hot shit. I'm excited about that. Now I don't need to worry about buying. Oh, but my magic power is too low! So I gotta leave some threshold amount of magic power, it looks like. Oh, right, SNK. I remember being really weirded out by that when I saw that. Like, really? Action RPG from SNK? Well, it's like Tecmo Secret of the Stars is a pretty good JRPG from a company that mostly made football games at the time. No, the some of the enemies, Kami, are immune to fire. The ones that can poison me are just outright immune to the fire sword. So that's why I was using the wind sword. So, apparently, having done that now qualifies me to climb the mountain. In the north, where it said that I wasn't strong enough before, now I'm strong enough. Yeah, we can switch to the fire sword now. Since we don't have enemies that are immune anymore. This is the training guy? Yeah, we'll go somewhere else. It's over by the... Yeah, Game Saucer, I think that'd be really cool. I've only ever played about an hour or two of Star Tropics. I don't think Cloud Reaver's in chat anymore, but him and his wife are really into the series. Star Tropics 1 and 2 for the NES. Now, was Chartropics 2 not any good? Hey! Food here is great. I wish I could eat like this always. Really? Like, you wouldn't let me come here because I wasn't strong enough? I am Nadare. Get rested and awake refreshed. Oh, that's cool. I have to get another antidote just in case. Tempted to pick up a warp boots because I don't have any MP. $50? Jeez. Not long ago, a guy from Bryn Mawr left to climb the mountain. I envy the youth with so much energy. I may be old now, but in my youth, I could climb many mountains easily. My son is still a wimp compared to me. Alright, so the next question is, how much MP does it actually cost to teleport, and does this area count as a teleport location? It does, perfect. So we can be super cheap. We can go to Bryn Mawr, to go to the inn, and then teleport back. I thought the old guy up here, but not me. What the shit? Thanks, game. It doesn't actually cost the 20 MP until you go to the town, which is nice. Back to the healing spell, and we'll get moving. Ha! Yeah. Pretty excited to do Secret of Evermore on stream. Is it still on the voting spreadsheet? It was one of the first games I added on there, and it doesn't get a ton of play, but it's as far as votes go. No, I think it came down because nobody was voting for it. It's too bad. Evermore is fun. Oh wait, no, it is on there. It's in the. It's a longer game than I remembered. Yeah, the exhibition went game 04. Some strange people, they put me in a cave. I also saw people from Leaf. They were all being forced to work, but I escaped and they found me. I cannot move. Oh, to have tasted Nadari's food again. He's already dead, man. That's dark for an NES game. Five feet from the inn? Yeah, that's really grim, poor guy. I hear someone talking. Those worthless villagers working well? Well, they're used to the cold weather, and I haven't heard complaints, but of course it's difficult to complain when you're not allowed. Must make them work harder. Long live the Dragovia Empire. Those guys sound like dicks. I like Mario Kart. I'm not as good at other kinds of racing games, but I would be happy to play them. Like, I need to do, it's not a racing game, but I need to do Grand Theft Auto on stream at some point. Those games are awesome. Not enough to make it up this thing. It's really a long shortcut. I guess he fell down that big slide, and that's what killed him. Oh, right, yeah, but he made it the other way around. He made it within 10 feet of the inn on his way back and then died. Now he like left the inn and then just died immediately outside. Attack! Human enemies, ooh, and they're immune to fire. Nice. Let's go rescue the village people. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. You guys are also probably immune to fire. I think it's like their family is immune. It's the old palette swap thing. Oh right, I have to put this back on, don't I? There we go. Yeah, they're immune to fire. Okay. Good to know. Oh, shit. Poisoned? Man. Thanks, game. Good looking out. Driver parallel lines. Sounds cool. What kind of game is it? Like, open world driving? What are these things? Oh, they should be like underwater creatures. Yeah, no, I'm with you, Sir Cucumber. I'll play any game from any genre. It's awesome, we should play it. If it's sub-block, then you get to pick whatever game you want, whether it's awesome or not. No one's made me play an hour of Superman 64 yet, but doesn't mean it won't happen eventually. These guys just have a ton of hit points, looks like. I don't know if they, like, regenerate when you knock them off screen. No, they just have a shit ton of hit points. Sometimes NES games would work that way. Good way to hint to you the best way to fight him. That sounds pretty cool, Game Saucer. Is it multiplayer? Not gonna bother fighting these guys because they take a bajillion hits to kill. Maybe that's because I'm underleveled. So expensive. Yeah, I think the other way may have been a secret. We might backtrack here soon. I'm gonna see what's over this way first. That sounds good. Alright. Speaking of level up, I think there's a hidden, like, numerical damage stat. If this were a modern game, you'd see little nice floating damage numbers. Enough to use the level 2 attack. I'm gonna start not blowing up ice walls unless if I actually walk through them. Oh shit, wasted some MP. Gotta be really careful not to do that. Can't just hold down the button with this one. You can suspend the charge while you still have the button held down by moving. There's an interesting strategy in doing that. I think that's where, if we drop down here, it would take us back to the inn. We need to save at least 20 MP so we can port out of here. Something bad happens. Just out of curiosity, can I climb this? Oh, maybe. See what's in this cave first. Stuff's in that cave. Oh, maybe not. Has to be slightly shorter than that, I think. What if we jump first? No, just too tall. It's too bad. Got it. Yeah, that could be cool. Or even the inverse would be fun, where it's immune to the level 2. But weak against the level 1. Okay, so it was just for an extra enemy. Didn't actually lead to anything. Because that's a way to loop around and farm money or XP if you need to. Fortunately, they're kind of dumb and swing the sword when they're coming at you, so you can take advantage of that. Okay, that's just a dead end. Switch to the fire sword. Switch to the ball of fire as well. Hey, rescuing people. So you saved us. Big deal. Thanks for saving me. Don't be such an asshat. So you saved us, big deal. No manners. This one also a cell. People of Dragonia. Hail, hail, Dragonia, a land I didn't make up. The elder is held prisoner at the top of the mountain, and they will kill him if we don't work. Thank you for saving me. There are village people in the next prison as well. Or the part of the prison wall is connected to the top. Yeah. Whoa. No. Problem is neither of these attacks penetrate. I'd probably just avoid them. Oh, ouch. Oh, that's rude. Attack me and knock me back into the cave I just came from? Uh-oh. I am the General Kelbesk. I'm one of Dragonia's finest four. Wimp, you will now see the wrath of my power. Okay, he's immune to fire. Holy shit, he hits like a truck. Dude, we're super dead. It'll take a while to get back here too with full MP. It's easy to get stuck in a corner against this guy too. Alright. Oh shit! Tried to hit the button, but it was too late. That's a bummer. That's a bummer. Hold on, before the autosave poses me. Oh no, it autosaved on the game over! Oh no, that's really bad. Oh, I probably need to set it to a longer window.
That's a bummer.
That's a bummer. Yukipo, are you going to keep this as your sub-block game? Because if so, I'll get back to where I was off stream for the next time we play it and jump over to Brilli Default. NES games. Oh, wait, no, we're okay. Oh, thank you. Thank God. It turns out that the game is super, super forgiving when it comes to the actual, like, continue mode. Okay, we're going to fix the... Let's go with... 5 minutes between saves. There we go. And let's do quick save state right now. Okay. Well, we'll keep playing. I'm gonna try that boss fight again. We technically still need about 5 more minutes on Crystallis. Thank you, game, for soft saving in that room. Holy shit. Think of an NES game that's that kind. There aren't really any that come to mind. And I was super bummed there for a sec, like, oh, I have to play this. Ouch. Sucks because the little things are flickering in a way that I can't always see them. This fight is not easy. That's an antidote. That's not gonna do me any good. I need to not get hit. Easier said than done. Good for Crystallis. I'm really glad to hear that. Okay, one more try. See if we can get to him without losing all of our progress. See if we can get through this hallway, too. Without taking any unnecessary damage, it makes that fight harder. I'm not gonna get another level up before the fight. That's 1 point of unnecessary damage. Probably use one of the medicines out of combat. It's gonna have the same net effect. Oh, can I switch to this to not waste MP there? Okay, good. Okay, cool. I'm just gonna cut straight and go up. The game content's not a problem for me, so long as it's not actually banned on Twitch. That would be the only thing that would keep me from playing a game. It's like, GTA is fine. God, like, the sprite flicker. There's so many of them on the screen that they become invisible at some point. I love how tricky this is because of having to stop to charge your sword. That's such a smart mechanic. I wish Zelda had done that, or instead of like just being at full health. I think I like that better. Because there's a real penalty to standing still, you know? Can't see the goddamn shit. Don't think you've seen even a fraction of my power. Next time you see me, it will be your last. Eat it. General Kelbesk left a treasure chest. Flame bracelet. Hell yes. Alright. Cool. So that's going to be a perfect stopping point, I think. We'll go ahead and do a manual save here. Good looking out. Yeah, no, I wouldn't. If the purpose of the game is to be lewd, then I'm not interested in it. In general, I'll veto stuff like that. But I think that a couple of those are. Isn't Yandere Simulator banned? All right, so we're gonna throw up the BRB. We'll be back shortly with some Bravely Default. Thank you to all of the subscribers today. Today we featured Acrolith with some Sunless Sea. Had a lot of fun with that one. I'd never played it before.